Wages can vary depending on the worker's educational attainment, work experience, and other factors that affect his or her skill level. Since the 1980s, the United States and other advanced countries have seen their wage inequality deteriorate due to the ever-widening gap in wages. It is widely believed that the problem is rooted in skill bias technical change, or SBTC. Specifically, the rapid pace of technological progress has demanded an increasing number of high-skilled labor. The shortage of such workers has raised their wage levels and aggravated the wage gap between high-skilled and low-skilled workers. During the past 40 years, Korea's wage gap has exhibited ups and downs, following a different path from that of advanced countries. But why? To answer this question, KDI examined how the wage gap has changed with a focus on educational attainment. From 1980 to 1994, the wage gap continued to narrow, as the brisk growth of the heavy and chemical industry bolstered the demand for mid-skill high school graduates. In comparison, the demand for high-skill college graduates and low-skill middle school graduates fell. In this period, high school education expanded rapidly, but could not meet the surging demand for high school graduates, and the latter group's wage levels rose relative to that of college graduates. Meanwhile, middle school graduates fell rapidly in number, helping the remaining members of this group to improve their position relative to high school graduates. Under such circumstances, the wage gap was eased by the relative increase in the wages of high school graduates and middle school graduates. From 1995, the development of ICT fueled the demand for college graduates. However, supply was unable to meet demand, driving up the wages of college graduates. Accordingly, the wage gap between college graduates and other groups began to widen. Since 2008, the demand for college graduates has stalled, lowering their wages and serving to alleviate the wage gap. In a sense, the easing of wage inequality lies with a downward convergence toward lower levels of wage across different educational attainments. The downturn in the demand for college graduates seen during this period may be due to the slowing of SBTC.
우리나라에서 임금은 1980년대부터 1990년대 중반까지는 매우 빨리 상승했습니다. 그러다가 1990년대 중반부터 둔화되기 시작했습니다. 특히 2008년 금융위기 이후에 지난 10여 년간 중위임금 그리고 상위임금이 거의 정체 상태를 보이면서 전반적으로 임금이 하향 평준화되는 모습도 나타났습니다. 전체적으로 임금 수준을 다시 높이기 위해서는 생산성 향상에 초점을 맞춰서 다각적인 노력을 기울여야 합니다. 규제 완화, 산업 구조 조정, 기득권 해소 이러한 노력이 필요합니다. 문제는 이렇게 했을 때 임금 불평등이 악화될 수도 있다는 것입니다. 여기에 대비해서 대학 교육의 질을 높이고 재분배 정책도 강화해야 한다고 생각합니다.